we will start the new topic, that is human settlement. Settlement is basically human response to natural conditions. Man is responding to nature through settlement, how to assimilate, how to acclimatize the given climatic conditions. मनुष्य अपने आप को अलग अलग तरह की जलवायु और भौगोलिक सिस्टम में कैसे एडजस्ट करता है, सेटलमेंट सिस्टम उसका एक उदाहरण है. किस तरह का सेटलमेंट है, कितने तरह के घर होते हैं, अलग अलग जगह, कई जगह थैच्ड हाउस मिलते हैं, झाड़ फूस के घर मिलते हैं, कई मिट्टी के घर मिलते हैं, कई जगह लकड़ी के घर मिलते हैं, बेम्बू हाउसेज, समटाइम्स मड हाउसेज, ब्रिक हाउसेज, and sometimes khaprel houses, sometimes cemented houses, sometimes you have glass houses, sometimes you have tented houses, sometimes you have leather tents, sometimes you have cloth tent, like Maasai people used to have the kraal, Bedouins make the tents with the cloth, Mongol people, Uzbek people, Tajik people, Kachak people, they used to make the tent with the help of the skin of the Bactrian camel. In the polar region, Eskimo people, Sami people, Lapps people, Inuits people, they used to construct houses with the snow, that is called igloo. So there are different houses, types of houses, single story houses, multi story houses, rural houses, urban houses, the nature of houses keep changes in different geographical areas. This is very interesting interpretation of human behavior in different geographical conditions. But settlement को क्या प्रभावित करते हैं? Basically, किसी भी स्थान की location, location of any place, location. Location may be plain, location may be plain plus water, location may be plain plus water plus fertile soil. How many conditions? So only plain, plain with water, plain with water and fertile soil, the nature of settlement changes in all the conditions. Sometimes settlement is very close, houses are very close to each other, sometimes houses are away from each other. So location is plain, maybe location may be plateau, location may be mountains, location may be plain. So in different locations, settlement, nature of settlement is altogether, you will find a great difference. Settlement is sometimes determined by the carrying capacity of the region. How many houses will be there in a particular area? Kitne log zinda reh sakte hain wahan? Utne hi to ghar banenge. Usse zyada ghar banenge to log dur chale jayenge. And number of houses are determined by the fertility of the soil, carrying capacity of the soil, sustainability of the region. Us ilake mein kitne log, you know, in mountainous region, in mountains, all houses are away from each other. But in plains, all houses are close to each other. In Punjab, in Haryana, you will find two houses have common wall. But in Uttarakhand, you will find two houses are as far away from each other as much possible. Why? Because it is determined by the carrying capacity of the region. In mountainous region, every person requires more and more area for their survival. ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा area मुझे चाहिए. तो क्या होगा मेरे पशुओं के लिए, मेरी फसल के लिए? Because carrying capacity is limited. कुछ थोड़ा बहुत कहीं कुछ हो जाए. सो ज्यादा से ज्यादा एरिया के लिए क्या करेगा, ज्यादा दूर जाके बसेगा. सो देयर विल बी वन हाउस, सो ही विल, ए पर्सन विल फाइंड मोर एरिया फॉर देयर सर्वाइवल. एंड अनदर, दूसरा घर से जितना दूर जाके बसेगा उसको उतना ही ज्यादा एरिया मिलेगा सर्वाइवल के. सो इट इज द सर्वाइवल कैरिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ द रीजन डिटरमाइन द नेचर ऑफ द हाउसेस. वाटर इज द लोकेशन. अपार्ट फ्रॉम लोकेशन सिचुएशन, सिचुएशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पैरामीटर. समटाइम्स सेटलमेंट में सिचुएशन इज से लोकेशन इज अ ब्रॉड टर्मिनोलॉजी. Mumbai is having the best location in the world, but Mumbai is having the worst situation in the world. Mumbai एक ऐसा शहर है, दिल्ली से एक ट्रेन गई है, उतने ही लोग अगर शाम को ट्रेन से वापस नहीं आए तो लोगों को रहने के लिए जगह नहीं मिलेगी वहां. मुंबई में मानसून का फिक्स टाइम है, 10 जुलाई को मानसून आनी है. अगर मानसून 12 जुलाई को आ गई तो दो दिन में मुंबई में हाहाकार मच जाएगी, पानी नहीं मिलेगा. लोकेटेड ऑन द कोस्ट, इफ अमाउंट कितनी भी बारिश होती है उससे 10 सेंटीमीटर ज्यादा बारिश आ जाए तो फ्लड हो जाएगा, और जितनी बारिश आनी चाहिए उससे 10 सेंटीमीटर कम हो तो पानी का अकाल पड़ जाएगा. व्हाट इज दिस? खाने के लिए स्पेस, दे डोंट हैव एक्स्ट्रा स्पेस. स्पेस क्रंच इज देयर, रिसोर्स क्रंच इज देयर, वाटर क्रंच इज देयर. और सिचुएशन वाइज दिस इज द वर्स्ट सिचुएशन. सिचुएशन मींस लोकेशन विद इन लोकेशन. जैसे आप कभी घर खरीदने जाते हैं, ओके राजौरी गार्डन इज गुड लोकेशन. आप अपने लिए पीजी के लिए घर देखने जाते हैं, राजौरी गार्डन इज गुड लोकेशन. ओके दैट इज द लोकेशन यू आइडेंटिफाइड ब्रॉड एरिया. बट विद इन लोकेशन जब आप कमरा देखेंगे, वेदर इट इज एयरी, वेदर इट इज सनलाइट, whether it is ventilated, whether it is cross air is there, whether it is having the balcony, whether we can face the sunlight, these are the situations, situation of the location. So situation is the location within location. So that is situation is playing vital role. If it is the sometimes location may be lake facing location, location may be sea facing location, location may be forest facing location, location may be cliff forest facing location, or like there are the different locations and within location there are the different situations. Location sea facing location, but waves aati hai kya usme? Sea waves ka direction mein hai kya? So it is again very dangerous to live over there. But it is windward winds are there, sorry, outgoing winds are prominent, so that is good place to live. So basically, the powerful winds nahi chalti, that is the, that location is good, that situation is good within the location. Lake facing, like in Nainital, there are the two types of location. Lake is there, lake ke charo taraf settlement hai. One settlement is the one which never get sunlight throughout the year because of the shadow of the mountain on one side. Nainital में एक location ऐसी है, नैनी lake के पास, जहाँ साल भर उस mountain की shadow की cliff की shadow की वजह से वहाँ particular साल भर धूप नहीं आती. So that is partly uninhabited area. The price of the coast is very cheaper over there. That is for commercial purpose, not for residential purpose. So basically situation is playing vital role for the settlement. Apart from that, the availability of water. Water is very important component of settlement. All settlements, we have the two types of settlement, dry point settlement and the wet point settlement. Wet point and dry point. In India, all over the world, not only in India, everywhere in the world, 95% of the settlements are the wet point settlement. Wet point settlement means any settlement, koi bhi gaon, kasba, seher, temporary, permanent, kaisi bhi settlement ho, wahan there should be a permanent source of water, maybe a river, stream, rivulet, water pond, groundwater, well, कुछ ना कुछ तो पानी जरूर मिलना चाहिए, वहाँ तालाब होना चाहिए, कुआ होना चाहिए, वाटर स्टोरेज टैंक हो, रिवर हो, जमीन में पानी हो, सो वी कैन पंप इट आउट, सो रिवलेट हो, कैनाल हो, देयर शुड बी अ सोर्स ऑफ वाटर, अदरवाइज अ सेटलमेंट कैन नॉट बी टेक प्लेस, ए सेटलमेंट कैन नॉट टेक प्लेस. देन देयर इज ड्राई पॉइंट सेटलमेंट. Dry point settlement generally used to found in the area with excessive rainfall, जहाँ ज़्यादा बारिश होती है और साल भर बारिश होती है और ज़्यादा बारिश हो और साल भर बारिश हो तो क्या होगा, पानी से दूर जाके बसेगा. In western Himalayas and eastern Himalayas, particularly in Purvanchal, in Nagaland and in Mizoram, most of the mountainous settlement in western Himalayas, most of the settlements are in the valley, lower side of the valley, closer to water, because jitna pani ho to niche hi aayega na. So most of the settlements in western Himalaya, in Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand, they are near the valley, near the water, not on the top. But if you go to Mizoram or in Purvanchal or in Arunachal, most of the settlements are here on the hillocks, on the top of the hill. They are the wet point settlement and they are the dry point. Whatever the rain takes place, immediately water is washed out. So dry point settlement and the wet point settlement are the two types. Water is playing vital role for the formation or development of the settlement. Every settlement has a life cycle. Koi bhi settlement shuru hota hai aur khatam ho jata hai, whether it's a village or a city. So it depends what are the conditions prevailing in the region. So like so many cities, like Kashi has disappeared, Kashi, Nalanda has disappeared, Takshila has disappeared. So many cities, they are disappeared. Some new cities are coming. Azadi ke baad, after independence in India, hundreds of the new industrialized cities mushroomed in different corners of the country. Like Baroni was not the city earlier, now Baroni is the city. Modi Nagar was not the city. Bhilai was not the city. Bokaro was not the city earlier. Durgapur was not the big city. Now they are the big cities. Bongaigaon was small village, now it became a city. Namrup was small. Namrup was there, but Noonmati, now it's a big city. So because of the industrialization, many new cities comes up and so every city has a life and conditions, what condition. Another important aspect is without water no settlement can take place. Water is the important source of development of a settlement. Jada bharpoor pani hai to population would be bigger and keep increasing. Identifying the Delhi as a city, as a capital city of India, not only by Britishers but by Mughals also, even the all previous rulers in India, they identified Delhi because of the geographical locational advantages. Delhi has plain fertile agricultural land, vast hinterland, regular supply of water round the year, plain fertile area, plain area is easily accessible, fertility provide different variety of crops, all these conditions, and it is centrally located. From here we can control the northwest frontier, we can control the Himalayas, we can control the coastal regions of the country. So otherwise Gwalior, Jhansi, Indore, they were the even much better location, but they were not identified because of the geographical conditions. Water was not there, plain was not there. Location would have been good, but situation, water and the climate is the another factor which determine the climate. So climate should not be extreme, I said, for any kind of habitation. What kind of climate determine the nature of settlement. Like wherever climate is directly or indirectly related to the carrying capacity of the plant, the pauda jinda reh jayega, because our human life is controlled by the plant or agriculture. So we can have agriculture if a plant can survive. When plant cannot survive, how the man can survive? So it is the human survival is more or less linked with the survival capacity of the plant. So in such condition, it is plant is playing vital role. And climate determine extreme temperature, you know, Rajasthan, western Rajasthan, where plant cannot survive, the nature of settlement is different. In Himalayas, after the height of 3000 meter, 3000 meter yuchai ke baad plant nahi hote. So we have few plants, mosses, ferns, lichens, trees with stunted growth, yuchai uche nahi hote. So we have after 3000 meter of height or 4000 meter of height, 4000 meter is the snow line, approximate snow line of Himalayas. 4000 meter ke baad jitna Himalaya sab barf se dhaka hua hai. So we have adverse conditions. So at 3000 beyond height of Himalayas, we have the different kind of vegetation, different type of habitation. Hai na, gharon ki nature alag ho jati hai kyunki temperature is extreme. Very either very cold or very hot. So in extreme temperature, extreme climate, extreme means very hot or very cold or very hot, dry or wet. Either it is dry or wet or cold or hot. When we have the extreme climate, habitation, it changes the nature of habitation. So these are the some situation, location, climate, water, some historical factors are also playing vital role. Some cities are historically developed, so historical development provide a kind of snowballing effect for the further development of the city. Delhi ke badhne ka karan historical factor raha because it was the city already developed by the Mughals. So Britishers developed at the same place because they find the workforce. And if the Britishers find after independence same infrastructure, it keep growing up. So the already existing historical factors supported the further growth of the city. So any habitation, historical factors are playing. Apart from that, economic conditions. Economic conditions means minerals, fertile soil, coastal locations, availability of fisheries, availability of food in other forms, they are supporting for the development of the any settlement. Jahan bhi insaan rahega zinda rehne ke liye, man has been migratory. Jo hum sab log jahan rehte hain, maybe our forefathers were not living over here, they must have migrated. So all throughout the human history, man keep migrating from one place to another in search of the better livelihood and better economic conditions. Ultimately, we keep changing the habitations and the nature of houses. So overall, jahan economic conditions suitable only, survival ki possibility hongi, hum wahi jaake ghar banayenge. So those sometimes we have the temporary houses, sometimes we have the seasonal houses, sometimes we have the permanent houses. So wherever the permanent houses are there, we have the better living conditions. The overall, the if we go to the human development or the different stages as given by the Rostow model, the primitive stage to take off stage and stage of mass consumption, Rostow gave five different stages of development. In the first stage of the development, you may find they don't have permanent house. They have thatched house, temporary house, migratory house. Then they have maybe temporary. But as the development is going on, settlement become permanent and planned. So basically, broadly, we have the two types of settlements. One is the genetic settlement, which evolved over the time at a particular place according to the need of the people and the development of technology. Jaise koi gaon bana, dheere se kuch log aaye, वो अपनी जरूरत के हिसाब से बस गए। 100 साल बाद टेक्नोलॉजी बढ़ी तो उन्होंने उसको थोड़ा सा चेंज कर लिया और बड़ा हो गया। 200 साल के बाद उस गांव की आकृति और बड़ी हो गई, जरूरत के हिसाब से उसकी गलियां टेढ़ी मेढ़ी जैसे बनता चला गया, उसी को कनेक्ट करते रहे। सो दैट इज जेनेटिक सेटलमेंट दैट इवॉल्व फ्रॉम द एट ए प्लेस ओवर द टाइम एज पर नीड। जैसे दिल्ली का हाल हुआ, मुगल्स ने बसाया, फिर ब्रिटिशर्स ने डेवलप किया, फिर पोस्ट इंडिपेंडेंस डेवलपमेंट हुई, फिर जब तक डीडीए नहीं बना एक अलग डेवलपमेंट हुई, प्राइवेट बिल्डर्स ने दिल्ली को डेवलप किया, फिर डीडीए बना दिया, फिर डीडीए ने अपने तरीके से डेवलप किया, फिर डीडीए डेवलपमेंट में फेल हो गया, देन स्लम अपने आप पैदा हो गए, स्लम कॉलोनी, अनऑथराइज कॉलोनी, इलीगल कॉलोनी, हैफेजार्ड कॉलोनी, कॉमन लैंड पे, पास्चर लैंड पे, एग्रीकल्चर लैंड पे, रेलवे लाइन पे, सब जगह जब खाली जगह थी वहाँ स्लम्स पैदा हो गए। सो क्या हुआ, दिल्ली अर्बन सेटलमेंट बिकम अ कैलिडोस्कोपिक मोज़ेक काइंड ऑफ फिल्म, कहीं अनऑर्गेनाइज सेटलमेंट आ गया। सो दीज आर द जेनेटिक सेटलमेंट्स ओवर द टाइम विद नीड इट ग्रो इट इवॉल्व ओवर द टाइम। सेकेंड टाइप ऑफ सेटलमेंट इज द प्लैंड सेटलमेंट और द सुपर इम्पोज्ड सेटलमेंट। वेन द यूरोपियंस मूव टू ऑस्ट्रेलिया और न्यूजीलैंड और अमेरिका और कैनेडा, दे प्लान द एरिया इन स्ट्रेट लाइन्स, लाइक एंटायर कैनेडा सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट कंट्री इन द वर्ल्ड इज डिवाइडेड टू ए ग्रिड ऑफ 2 किलोमीटर बाई 2 किलोमीटर, एंड एवरी पूरे कंट्री में 2 किलोमीटर बाई 2 किलोमीटर के ग्रिड में हमने डिवाइड किया हुआ है पूरा कैनेडा। And the same is like America, and all roads are 2 kilometer by 2 kilometer. Then उसके अंदर further road, major roads are 2 kilometer by 2 kilometer. Grid system is there. So every settlement will take in a planned order on a demarcated site, having following all the rules and regulations. So settlement is planned and imposed. It is not evolved over the time genetically. उसको हमने जरूरत के हिसाब से develop किया है. So that is the second type of settlement. Broadly, we can say we have the rural habitation and the urban habitations. Rural is the broadly we can say which where occupation is primary occupation. जो लोग primary activities करते हैं, agriculture, farming, different type of farming, intensive, subsistence, commercial, cash crop, dry land, irrigated, labor intensive. Commercialization, whatever the crop, agriculture, horticulture, fishing, animal husbandry, hunting, gathering, कोई भी activities, जब when majority of the people are engaged in these primary activities, that is called rural habitation. But in some countries there is no clear cut demarcation. Some countries they may have like what is the size? Which countries make the size of the habitation is up to 1,000 people? Okay, it is rural. If it is more than 1,000, it becomes urban. But in India, it is not like that. In India, we have different census department have identified 3 conditions for a region to become a city or a urban. Every area cannot be pronounced as urban. There are certain reasons. So, population size is one of the criteria, like in India, which is the urban area. Urban area, one is the criteria is population size of the habitation. 5,000 aur usse jyada log honge to wo urban honge. Second criteria is density. Density is 1000 person per square kilometer, usse jyada density hogi to it will be declared as the urban area. 1000 person per square kilometer. Sorry, 1 square mile, 1,000 person per square mile, or the 400 per square kilometer is the criteria. But these criteria are varying. The third criteria is the most important criteria, that is male working population. Indian census is gender biased in terms of that. They said male working population share is if it is more than 75%, जितने पुरुष लोग काम करने वालों की संख्या है उसके 75% और उससे ज्यादा एग्रीकल्चर में लगे हुए हैं तो वो विलेज कहलाएगा. एंड द फोर्थ क्राइटेरिया इज देयर शुड बी नोटिफाइड म्युनिसिपैलिटी. ग्राम पंचायत होगी तो वो गांव होगा, म्युनिसिपैलिटी होगी, काउंसिल होगी, सिटी कैंटोनमेंट होगी तो वो शहर हो जाएगा. लाइक बट सर्टेन एक्सेप्शंस आर देयर. गांव होगा या शहर होगा, लाइक ए कैंटोनमेंट, आर्मी की कैंटोनमेंट, दे आर नॉट डूइंग एग्रीकल्चर. इफ ए कैंटोनमेंट साइज इज 1000 जवान्स आर देयर, 1000 सोल्जर्स आर देयर, 5000 तो नहीं हुए, दे आर ओनली 1000, बट दे विल प्रोनाउंस एज अर्बन हैबिटेशन बिकॉज देयर ऑक्यूपेशन इज नॉन एग्रीकल्चर. लाइक समटाइम्स से ए सिटी से बद्रीनाथ, बद्रीनाथ इज ए प्लेस इन हिमालयाज, इज ए हिंदू प्लेस फॉर वर्शिप, वेरी प्रोमिनेंट हिंदू प्लेस फॉर वर्शिप. इन विंटर द एब्सोल्यूट नंबर ऑफ रेजिडेंट्स आर लेस देन 500 nowadays इन द सिटी. एंड एज पर सेंसस देयर पॉपुलेशन इज नॉट टचिंग 5000. But in summer, population of the this city Badrinath never get down from 25,000 person every time in summer. But they are not permanent. Garmi mein 25,000 se zyada log rahenge har samay city mein. Winter mein wahi 500 log ki raste band ho jate hain. So it means, but the permanent residents of the city are less than 5,000. But that is declared as city. We have given a city council status to the region because occupation is different. Occupation is non-agriculture. They are extending services to the God in the name of God, worship, place of worship. So we have different conditions. Always we cannot say this can be a rural area or this can be a urban area. But the most important is on the basis of rural and urban. In urban we have the different hierarchies. We have the township, chota sa kasba jisko kehte hain, city, metropolitan city, mega city and the cosmopolitan city or the multi mega city. So like Delhi having one of the largest human agglomeration on the earth surface is located in continuity in and around Delhi. Delhi, Gurgaon, Noida, Faridabad, Ghaziabad, up to you can say Dharuheda, or you know Bahadurgarh, or the industrial area Kundli, all they are together, they are in continuity without any break or without any gap. But administrative units are different. It is divided into four different administrative units. But human settlement is in continuity. Delhi is the snowballing effect for the development of this large city. So though we have developed the NCR for developing the counter-magnet towns, countering Delhi and attracting the immigrants in those cities. But वो दिल्ली के आसपास हमने बहुत सारे शहरों को दिल्ली का प्रेशर कम करने के लिए NCR बनाया कि दिल्ली में लोग ना आए. दिल्ली के बाहर आसपास इंडस्ट्रियल टाउन डेवलप किए, मानेसर डेवलप किया, दारूहेड़ा डेवलप किया, रेवाड़ी डेवलप किया, भिवाड़ी डेवलप किया. सो वी हैव डेवलप्ड खुर्जा, वी आर डेवलपिंग बुलंदशहर, वी आर डेवलपिंग मेरठ, मोदीनगर, मुरादाबाद, हापुड़, वी आर डेवलपिंग, जस्ट वी आर डेवलपिंग इंडस्ट्रीज कि लोग सब दिल्ली में ना आए, दिल्ली के आसपास इन शहरों में आए. बिकॉज दिल्ली द कैरिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ दिल्ली हैज एक्सीडेड, द पॉपुलेशन हैज एक्सीडेड द कैरिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ दिल्ली सिटी. दिल्ली में जितने लोग रह सकते हैं उससे ज़्यादा लोग यहाँ आके आ चुके हैं. सो दिल्ली सिटी वी डोंट हैव सब्सटेंशियल अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर और स्पेस और ट्रांसपोर्ट और पब्लिक यूटिलिटी फैसिलिटीज, तो दिल्ली में क्या हुआ, इतना ज्यादा प्रेशर हो गया कि यहाँ हर समय तो ट्रैफिक जैम रहने लग गया, रोड्स को बड़ा नहीं कर सकते, पानी रहता नहीं है, बिजली इन समर इट इज लिमिटेड सप्लाई। दिल्ली का काम इसलिए चल जाता है कि आसपास के गरीब पड़ोस के स्टेट में गरीबी है, वो लोग परचेज नहीं कर सकते इलेक्ट्रिसिटी।